WYFF News 4, live local breaking news at 6.
Good evening, I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. A break tonight in the shooting death of an Anderson man.
A 17-year-old is in jail tonight accused of the crime. News 4's Keisha Foster is live and local on the story. She's at the Anderson Police Department tonight. Keisha, good evening.
Good evening, Michael. That 17-year-old is Trayvon Mac Hayman, and we're told he turned himself in at 1 o'clock this afternoon. He is charged with one count of murder and one count possession of a firearm during the commission of a crime.
At this time, we're not releasing anything concerning the motive. It's something that we just don't want to comment on at this time because it's still under investigation.
Sergeant Tony Tilley with the Anderson Police Department says 34-year-old Yusef Jenkins was shot dead around 12:30 Friday morning outside the home of his girlfriend, Pamela Brownlee. It happened at 207 Sandalwood Drive. An arrest came just over 12 hours after the crime happened.
Witness statements. We took some witness statements on scene last night. We also had some examination of physical evidence, and then just good old-fashioned detective work from our investigators.
The coroner says Jenkins was shot multiple times.
And tonight, Mac Hayman is being held here at the Anderson City Jail. Keisha Foster, WYFF News 4, live in downtown Anderson.
Keisha, thank you. Greenville County deputies have arrested a man they say tried to kill his mother. Last night, deputies say Daniel Jason Pringle called 911 and told dispatchers that he stabbed his 70-year-old mother. She is in critical condition tonight. Pringle was taken into custody at the home, but deputies say he needed treatment for self-inflicted stab wounds as well. He is charged with attempted murder and possession of a weapon during a violent crime. Deputies are still investigating why Pringle attacked his mother.
Two men fell out of a boat during a fishing trip on Lake Greenwood this morning, and one of them drowned. The coroner tells us Jerry Lee Bowers Jr. died just after 11:30 this morning. He was 38 years old. Authorities tell us he was fishing with a friend in that John boat you saw a moment ago there. When one of the men moved to get a tackle box, the boat started taking on water. The Department of Natural Resources says the two started swimming for shore, but Bowers never made it. We're told the men had life jackets in the boat, but never managed to get them on.
South Carolina's unemployment is down for the second month in a row. The state reports the jobless rate dropped 0.3 points in February to 10.2%. The most added positions were in the leisure and hospitality industry, which grew by 4,600 jobs. At the same time, labor force shrank in the last year by almost 15,000 workers to 2.15 million. Which could mean discouraged workers leaving the job market.
GSP tonight is adding another airline. Vision Airlines will take off from the airport for the first time tonight. The carrier plans to operate flights 3 days a week from GSP to Destin, Florida. One-way, $19 fares will be available until Sunday. The normal prices will start at $89. Vision also plans to offer nonstop flights from Asheville to Destin and St. Petersburg, Florida, starting April 1st. This was day three for Bilo, giving away gas, and it drew a crowd again. Sky 4 was there again, this time at the Spink Station on John B. White Senior Boulevard in Spartanburg. It's a simple game. Bilo offers clues on its Facebook page and on Whistle 100 and WMYI. And people, lots of them, follow the clues. The first 100 drivers figured it out. They get there, receive a voucher for 20 gallons of free gasoline. That's about a $70 value. And the vouchers were all gone by 11:15.
If you plan to burn some gas for a weekend road trip, you'll need the wipers. Chief Meteorologist John Sesrich is here to talk a major change coming. And John, those wipers, big clue.
Big clue indeed, Carol. Yeah, we're talking about a couple of sprinkles right now just moving through the mountainous areas. Most of this precipitation is not even reaching the ground. The air is still very dry at the surface and also in the mid-levels of the atmosphere. This rain is certainly hitting the ground back in East Tennessee, and the rain is, in fact, even heavy at times moving over Knoxville right now. So not expecting any precipitation tonight in the upstate outside of the mountains. But what's going to happen this weekend is a front's going to pass by us tonight. A wedge of cold air is going to settle in, and for the entire weekend, expect a rainy weekend with chilly temperatures. And on average, most of us will see by the time this storm ends, sometime Sunday night, we'll probably see at least 1 inch of rain. We'll talk more about this storm system a little bit later on. Now back to you, Mike.
We'll be here and listening. John, thank you. We'll let you ponder this for a moment. What would you do with $300 million? How about $125 million? The Mega Millions drawing happens tonight. Powerball follows tomorrow. And as News 4's Nigel Robertson tells us, the jackpots, as evidenced by these very words, are making news.
Lottery fever is in full swing.
When it gets to be a big one, you gotta be in it to win it.
The Powerball jackpot is sitting at least $125 million. The Mega Millions, well over $300 million. Imagine what you would do.
Everything. everything that I can buy with the money. I'm going to buy me a car. I'm going to buy me a house. I'm going to buy my mama a house. Might even buy you a house. If I can.
As the owner of the Shell Quick Stop in downtown Greenville told us, people do win.
Yes, we had a big winner in scratch off the ticket called Black, $200,000.
From the long lines in Detroit to the long lines in New Jersey, those dreams of taking home the massive jackpot are everywhere.
I'll take whatever I can get.
Nigel Robertson, WYFF News 4, Greenville.
All right, if you bought a lotto ticket in Greenville yesterday, check your numbers because somebody bought a Palmetto Cash 5 ticket at the Garden Spot Food Store on Cedar Lane Road, and that ticket is now worth $400,000. Tickets, please. Here are the winning numbers again. 1, 4, 8, 20, and 31. The power-up number is 4, and yes, the ticket holder did pay the extra dollar, which multiplied the 100,000 winnings by 4.
Some of the nation's best grill masters are in town to please your palate. They're here for an industry trade show.
Yeah, but they're firing up the grills on Saturday to show off a little bit. You got to love that kind of showing off. News for Sean Mozzarella tonight with how you can get a bite.
They pull 600 pounds of pork a day at Henry's Smokehouse in Greenville. For some people, it's heaven on a bun. But Henry's has never entered their meat into a competition until now. They couldn't resist when the National Barbecue Association came to town this week for its annual conference. The group is celebrating its 20th anniversary. Well, this is their second time in Greenville. They like to open up part of the conference.